stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
At their own 25-yard line.
Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a 2nd and 5.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find them. To me, that's the magic number.
You give yourself your best chance. So if they're up around 24, 28, 30,
they could be a shootout. Welcome to lockdown, Chaz, nigga. Turn into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Welcome to lockdown, nigga. I'm up 30. Let's go. I ain't doing shit you want to do. I just want to welcome you to lockdown.
So a good run by Fournette. Now another 1st and 10. And to give this time to the tailback. Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left it no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Now he'll throw with Brady. And this one is incomplete. The Pro Bowler Chris Godwin, the intended receiver. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert.
Up 30.
3rd and 9. Working from the gun, it's Brady.
Yeah, my girl come back home today. I know I'm over again.
Fires one, but incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
Yeah.
That's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Hey, man, when I go to the preseason game Friday, man, next Friday, I'm going to goddamn run question. Across the field and get the police to tackle my little fucking ass.
17-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They've got a three-off
from the game. That'll be dick when you run.
They're going to start the drive here on the ground with Patterson. And he'll take this one up to about the...
Oh, no, that's still tacky, man.
5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
But you know they say whenever a motherfucker do that, they get banned for NFL games forever, bro.
Here's 2nd and 5.
I'm not ready to risk that no shit like that.
This time it's Davis. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1.
He was brought down by Logan.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
On 3rd down, it's Patterson. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a 1st down.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was 3rd and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you should have a two-man in the box there.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11. Now 2nd and 11 from the 32. Now they'll throw it with Ryan. And unsuccessful there, trying to dump it underneath. That'll bring up 3rd down.
Cordero Patterson, incomplete.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
And the 11.
On 3rd down, Ryan. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. Charles, I'm looking at you, and understandably, your mouth is wide open in disbelief. What were they thinking?
That's going to be one of the great mysteries, but I do know this. When they went out on offense, I will guarantee they told them, don't just make anticipatory throws. Make sure you see it before you throw it.
Damn, man, I fucked around him. Damn, he just slammed.
Second quarter now, and it's Buccaneer football, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation. Taken in the end zone. And Patterson will not return it. It comes out to the 25. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. Back to the air. Ryan after the pick six. And open, that's Calvin Ridley. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Man, you gotta catch that shit.
Here's Patterson. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 and the 39. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Second and 11 at the 39-yard line.
On second and 11 now. Ryan flushed out right. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Cordero Patterson, the one he was hoping to get it to. And it's third down.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
On third down, Ryan. That'll be taken in there by James Washington. And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line. Well short of the first. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. They'll indeed go for it with Ryan. And he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. They'll run on first down. Patterson, he'll get only a couple down to the 44.
By the running back.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
From the 44, Ryan to the right side and complete to Hurst. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Falcons! Calvin Ridley. Touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Falcons have retaken the lead. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7.
Makes the score Falcons 10, Buccaneers 7.
Damn.
The Hood LeBron. Is that Money Mitch?
Yeah.
The Hood LeBron is Money Mitch?
No, LeBron James.
Touchdown. Here's Koo to kick off. Taking it about the one.
Rhino, I thought you said this dude was. Sorry, this nigga was not sorry. It's pretty tough.
At their own 25-yard line.
Saints offense set to begin their next possession and hoping to do better than they did their last possession.
Y'all still playing in the league?
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them to get first place your feet. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you
or
do that, he's got the
AFC
first down. He wins.
Or JP.
Three, two, bro.
Touchdown. I'm in first place in the AFC.
Oh, okay.
Leonard Fournette, touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Buccaneers have once again taken the lead.
Yeah, you got an X-Fact on him. That's crazy.
I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use in that. Man. One play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. I'm not explosive. 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play. Big time result.
Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
He's coming.
He'll look to throw right away. And he gets this one to Ridley complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Late in the season now, MVP chatter starts, and he might
I got,
be on
I got
the
toughest this one, for sure. Well, you got verified love. I think he's tough.
Against him.
Does he deserve consideration?
He more than deserves consideration because the way the game is played in the NFL it's a pass-first league, right? So that means that people are going to adjust their defenses for him each and every week, and he's still putting up big-time numbers. I know the quarterbacks, the running backs get it, but he should be firmly in the race.
Oh, my fucking God.
Back-to-back good plays.
Wow.
On the move on first down. They run with Patterson. Solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down, it's Patterson.
Damn, I can't get it back.
This carry
not
as productive. He swallowed up at the
line
of scrimmage. Calling no game that time as it's going to leave
him
with a
bike.
3rd and about 3 to go.
Golly.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. 60 catches for him now on the year. This last one, a first down.
Now that's absolutely frustrating for a defender. Had a chance to get him on the ground before he got to the sideline. But what great vision and understanding where he is on the field as he headed for the marker and picked up the first down.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. Now they go screen. It's complete. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double
Get
10 here.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Ryan's pass taken in by Ridley, and he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. That was the 8th play of the drive, so a somewhat fitting pickup of 8 yards.
Brings up 2nd and 2.
Hey, Jiggy, you want to play for 500?
It's Patterson. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the
15. Hey, Glizzy.
It'll be a gain of 2 on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with 3rd down looming.
Hey, Glizzy.
Ryan. Got an open man. It against Washington. And he'll get nothing out of that one. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down. And this offense has converted twice already here in this first half on fourth down conversions.
And yeah, I heard again. He said that shit.
They're going on fourth down. It's Ryan. And that is going to be incomplete. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Buccaneers defense holds, and they get the football back. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in.
No, I don't know.
They weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but the loud run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. Now the Bucs going to use the first of the.
You got the game up, okay?
As he'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. He's got a first down and more past the 30. And all the way up to the 37-yard line. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
I don't know where he is, bro. There you go.
Bro, how is that not a fumble, dog?
I'm trying to bat 7. I ain't gonna lie. I'm on 7, nigga. He's really good, man. What up? Be five.
The Falcons take over.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And on the last.
No. Matter of fact, I could put 700 up. Most of these guys probably cover this shit.
Mentality this go around.
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times.
I trust Big N with it.
Coverage and it's intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan
about to bet the whole 700 left in this cash while we go.
Young Ray Crew, the kickoff for Atlanta.
The Bucs with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is
in. Man, y'all get it to 700 and it could be a bet. If it ain't up to 700, I ain't betting.
And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
Ooh.
Ow. Hold up, that's 700. Hold up.
To begin their next hold up.
I got the glizzy.
The interception. We'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. There's just a toss before every game. The team making the fewest mistakes will win.
Glizzy don't be fucking around, boy.
Shit, I take it.
Hey, what you say, Glizzy? Hey, but
I still ain't getting nothing to eat, though. Look, when I go get some, I'm going to get something to eat real quick. I'll be right back. That's cool, though. Look,
that one covers 29 yards. First down.
I don't go. Like, what are you talking about? Pace.
This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now the third-year man from USC.
Nah, dude, I'm on this spot. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Pushing through tackles.
I've been saying that. We've been playing since like 12. I've been saying that since 12.
I'm in love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also
if you can't play, when I get back, you can probably be on tonight. Like you can FaceTime. You can FaceTime me the whole time.
6 yards on
fuck,
that last
man, what type
play
of friendly shit is that? You call me fuck. You call. We can do it before our game. I'm about to get something to eat. I don't fuck that shit.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Leonard Fournette with touchdown number 23 here on the
year. I don't give a fuck about that 300, nigga. Fuck that shit. I'll get something to eat, make a couple plays, and fuck that shit, nigga. I'm kidding.
board right now.
Well, someone's all about winning because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. The bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
And this will make it
different game, Rondo.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. From the gun, it's Ryan. And it's complete. He gets this one to Washington. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It's a gain of 16, first down Falcons. 4-yard line. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And he'll complete this one to Patterson.
So fast.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Got the defense on their heels. 2 first downs in a row, and now a pickup of 8. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And he'll get it down here to the 43.
Talk Twitch.
A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Throwing again, Ryan. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line. Shaquille Barrett, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. He's going to, that's caught inside the 20. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Operating from the gun, Ryan. This one caught by Ridley. And they'll work this down to the 15 for a pickup of 4. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if he missed, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders.
Man, what the fuck got the fuck to say here?
Well, I know what version did you buy when you before you lost your account? 4 or 5.
That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line.
And the 4 or 5.
They have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. This will be caught at about the 5. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain there on the completion. It'll be second down.
Goal. Oh, you got both of them.
At the 4-yard line. Line of scrimmage. Again, the 4-yard line. Second and goal. And now a give. Right side. Patterson. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Cordero Patterson. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Falcons have cut it to within a score. Now Ryan leading the Falcons up to go for 2. Conversion. To throw is Ryan. And he's got it. So the try for 2 successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal.
21. Falcons 18.
Bruh.
touchdown. Here's Koo to kick off. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25.
Hey, Justin Houston is a monster. 81 overall.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead.
Good stick, boy. Good stick.
They got to take that shit off of the game, dog. They got to take that shit there off of the fucking game.
And that'll be incomplete. Damn. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are in the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. After the penalty, it's Fournette.
Yes, baby.
They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. They lose two on that last play, so things get even tougher. Third and long coming up.
What's up, man?
Third down.
Man, look at this shit.
What do you want?
Back to the ground, this time with Jones.
Everybody locked up, JD.
And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain, and it leaves them looking at a fourth down.
We often talk of situational football. Let's just call it team football. The defense did their job, got off the field, brought the punting situation. So they're turning the ball back over to their offense. You think those guys will get along very well right now? Of course they will. Defense up the offense. Now it's their turn to take it downfield.
Their own 33-yard line. The Atlanta
offense out there. Oh, they just played me, bro.
And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters' blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
Once more, they turn to Patterson. And he'll get this out to about the 38-yard line. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
That's a gain of three. Now third and five.
Hey, Rondo, he going to totally see that for the second or the first half.
Complete, and he is going to have a Falcons first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven.
Get out of there. Oh, good tackle. Good tackle, fellas. Good tackle.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. First down.
I think it helped me to
it's
3 points
Patterson.
last game.
Time, getting it to about the 46.
Or 3 points last half.
Just a yard on the pickup.
Sure
it'll bring up a second and nine.
Yeah, things are pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately...
Oh, man, what the fuck? Oh, man.
On second and nine, Ryan finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner. And we watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself.
Bro, look at this goofy shit.
And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three.
shit.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Falcons on third down. They've hit on half of them. 5 for 10. This is third.
You beating him, Gray?
8-0.
Huh?
8-0.
From the gun. Ryan.
You said what, 0?
28-0.
And then why you act like you were so tough? Why you kept saying that?
5-pound and Dominican Sue finding the path to the QB there. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
They'll try and throw for it with Ryan.
Damn, motherfucker.
Right side, Tate. But they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead.
Great within your 4 minute offense here, Charles. Definitely. Remember, the 4 minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario: get enough first downs.
Who are you playing, Ronald?
And eat up their timeouts so the game ends. And he's a war guy.
95 overall, Ronald. 95 speed. 96
clock
speed.
Continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. They'll try and run some clock now with Jones. And he's got this down to the 35. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step
it's
aside
now,
here in
all
the fourth quarter. Fournette running out of the gun. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more, plus the two-minute warning. And we'll be back. Again, it's Fournette. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top five offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too...
Yeah, he's
with another touchdown, number 24 on the year. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
Yeah, that's good.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk
about
on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. What a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. Extra point put through by Suckum, and his guys will take a 10-point
lead. Hey, man, that Panthers dude must be real deal. He beat the Packers 56-24.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This taken in about 4 yards deep, and Patterson will not return it. It comes out to the 25.
25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Throwing now, Ryan on first down.
Damn, boy, what the fuck I ran into now?
Carlton Davis picks it. So now he's equal to his interception total from a week ago. Remember, Charles, he had three last week.
And you know, all week long, he vowed to take that number down.
I'm up 15, Jesse.
Don't worry, things are going to pick up. I've got this.
So I'm up 15. No, nigga, I'm going to say this shit. Look at something we're going to go down.
Cool, calm, collective rebounding. Not rebounding right here. That one good for 37 yards.
First and goal, Tampa Bay.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. The carry here for the big tight end.
I can hear him as well.
Into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Rob Gronkowski. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six.
Y'all deep in
there. He's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
35. Falcons 18.
Bradley. You should have beat the Panthers.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. On the return, here's a dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And a less than desirable return as he's out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover. They want to try to put points on the board.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds.
That's number one defense in the league right now as far as points.
Jason, you got to send it back. They wouldn't let me join.
I'm surprised with the way that this one has gone and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Where?
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second.
You playing Kyrie Robinson after this game for $100?
Yeah,
Rondo,
you got the
nigga, just send me my dad 15 and go play the nigga.
He's got a man complete.
Who the hell is Kyrie? Who is that?
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta.
Wow, what happened?
85 yards. And the Falcons cut into that lead.
I ain't know about it.
Because they're playing with the lead here late in the ball game, so the back defender has got to be as deep.
Bro,
as
the Panthers have 67 interceptions.
In front of you, rally up and make the play.
Yeah, you would think they had the 3-score lead. Now it's down to 2, but 3-score lead here.
I think I know you're talking about.
Give up a big pass play like that, but
the
they
Panthers
do
have 67 interceptions. Bro. Deep. I got 46, and I'm number 2.
That decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
Damn, nigga, Burnham playing for the damn Saints.
Did you hear me, Rondo?
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Rondo! Barring mistakes, they should be able to kneel.
I got 46 interceptions, bro. I'm number two by 21.
The side of the ball, so
nigga, I got really 21 interceptions, bro.
Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
MK, y'all boys still betting in that group?
Of course.
I'm saying, what y'all betting on baseball now?
I mean, I haven't really bet much, JP.
They have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game.
JP, yeah. You can bet on an argument in that group. And JC gonna be in the middle of every single one of them.
Football season. Hey, football season put me back in that bitch.
On third down.
Man, you crazy. You crazy in the motherfucker. Nigga, look, when we play, I ain't got nothing to do with that.
What's up? You ain't gonna get no bets in there, bro. They gonna kick you out because all you wanna do is straight up. They don't do straight up.
Man, they probably do a lot of straight up with knowing this is an NFL season.
You're gonna smother it? But a lot of the points, they come in a little bit high.
Never.
They don't have great leverage.
Always
and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
I remember before... And JP, I remember before I met JC, we was on Rondo's Facebook, and he was like, he had said, Ben, he said, points. I was like, points? Nigga, that's before I even got to the, you remember that, JC? It was before the Super Bowl.
So on fourth down, they decided to go with a run-pass option, a good decision.
And the run can get you there, but the pass gets you there quicker.
Nice decision. Yeah. Picks up a first down. So first and 10 now
JP, you,
from the
JP,
30.
You might as well get in there. It's such a good group. A shotgun to the same day.
And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line.
Hey, JC, you talking about this basketball nigga, just the Bucks alone.
I'm asking as well because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason.
Bucks alone, JP.
College, and how about the NFL?
I mean, it was insane.
They put the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up.
In one day,
what year was that? 1978. I think it was in November. So time has run out on what will be a Tampa Bay victory, and they were beating Charles by a big second half to put this one on ice.
Man,
so
you get the sense that whatever was said
at halftime, obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus. And maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing it better. And that got it done in this one. So for...
Look what I just put,
brother. My car's got my hand in there, but no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I do with I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winnings on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Jack and toes on your teeth. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. Four Giottos on the truck. I had a dream in the store. Living my life cause we young. Looking back at what I love. Why I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turn me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, got this scheming. Against our odds, like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Laying out on the line, ain't no looking back. Give up my all and I see the cracks. Get on the bottom, no Democrats. Spotlight on you, boy, how you gonna act? I remember
sleeping. Bro, your rushing defense is better than mine by 7 yards, bro. Passing defense got you by 600 yards.
I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my
feet. Why not? Why not? 334 or 340. I only allowed 188.
I've been grinding since young and they told me my timing was coming. I've been hustling my time to get all the fame, get the money. I'm not in that little sunny. I've been eating since young and since we ain't have food in our tummy. But you cannot check out
shit, how many games you play? 14. Let me see how many points I'm averaging. Yeah.
88.
188 divided by 14. Yeah, I'm giving up 13.4 points a game, KP.
Killing
me. Everyone's scoring, dude. Rhino, this one nigga is 90% on fourth down. Wow. And 55% on third down. That nigga don't want this. I'm 50% on third down, 70% on fourth down. Solid. Rhino, look at this red zone efficiency.
Man, dog, I got fucking hit. Come on.
52 times, the second most in the NFL.
Damn, so the quarterback don't fucking look at this shit.
And I'm shooting. I'd have been in the red zone 52 times right now. And I'm shooting. And I'd have scored 41 out of 52 times. 78%. Check this out. This is a hell of a stat right here. Niggas have been in the red zone with me 25 times. Guess how many times they scored total? 13. Shoot, 52%. Niggas is really not scoring. That's what's up. I like to see that. That's big defense. Yeah, that's what's up.
Here's your trade, Rhino.
That defense is... Rhino, I done gave away. I done gave the ball away 16 times. I'm taking it.
Spin the block around the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Gotta have a plan to leave the fans behind. We just ran in the spot, and then we spin the block around just like a hole in the clock.
Come like a No, I got the number one score defense for sure. I'm talking about number one overall as far as yards allowed. He got me by like a 90. I got the number one score defense by 70 points. Ain't no way I give it up the last two games. Ain't no way a nigga averages 70 points.
Niggas holding on to my ass.
Lamar Jackson elite league passing. He got 47 touchdowns right now, but he got 34 interceptions.
What I did, can I kick the ball? Some rain.
can I kick it? Tyreek Hill got 23 receiving touchdowns. Odell only has 10 receiving touchdowns.
Hey,
look, Tua got the number one touchdown, 49. God damn.
Shut the fuck up, nigga. Shut up. Shut up.
I'm top. Rondo, I'm top. Yeah, I'm top 10. I'm number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm number 6 in passing touchdown. But it's all defense, baby. I ain't gotta have all that extra. All big defense. Aaron Rodgers is shooting 70%. That's insane. You okay? What are you doing? 70% completion. Yeah. What is it? Are you for real? Colts is 81%. Yeah, damn. I'm 66%. But I got 14 interceptions. I got the second least turnovers. Or interceptions. I'm efficient. Go ahead, just down like that. Go ahead, just down like that. Go ahead, just down like that. Yeah, because he plays Jacob Love.
There we go. There you go. Brain Leonard, put that over here to me. You like Ronald? He get who?
Bucks.
Bet it up. I got the Eagles. Lock it. That one game, and then, hey, look, Ronald, we ain't look back. Tore your ass up the rest of the day. Tore your ass up for the rest of the day. Bye bye.
Oh, Ronald can play with the Chiefs. He can't play the Chiefs.
Nah, he can't do that with the Chiefs. Man, this nigga won't stop doing this shit, bro.
Marlon
Mack, yeah. Yeah, I had to find a defense. I bet you won't get him now.
I'll get him.
I guarantee you won't even get 100 if you play me again. And I, Rondo, you could not run that bitch yesterday after I found my little shit. No, you couldn't. Well, if you're running team and come back and see him, then. JC, I don't give a fuck. You can spot me 14, nigga, and I'm telling you, nigga. Hey, you already know what it is. Damn, we really gave up some shit like that? Man, we picked up motherfucker. What's his name? Luke Stocker? We pick up everybody old Tennessee dude, bro. We pick up all kind of old motherfuckers. We just picked up John Simon. You know, John Simon used to be good with the Pacers, but that motherfucker old, man. JC, you got your Lamar, I got me a Lamar. Let's go. Oh, hell no, nah. Don't try my nigga like, oh, that's supposed to be a pig. Don't try my nigga like that. pick. Yeah, this is what I do. I spot this nigga 14 points and come back and get his ass. That's what I do. That's what the fuck I do. Spot that nigga 14. Nigga, I done spot that nigga 3 times. 117, 114, this one 4. Nigga, goddamn, 3 times. Nigga, I spot this nigga.
Spot this nigga. All three,
man, look, MK, the first game we played today, nigga was up 17-0, beat him. Second game, he was up 14-0, beat him. This game, he was up 14-0, he about to beat him.
Damn.
Nigga.
JC, ain't no lead safe with you, bro.
Hell no. Come on, Raheem. We get to the fourth. I got to have a magnificent play. Fuck it. Fuck the four. Fuck the four. We don't care about no damn four, man. You can get out of here. This bitch over with 42-21. I spotted that nigga 14. Let's go.
God, damn.
Spotted that nigga 14. Back up 30, nigga. I ain't been no whole nothing. Ain't you about to play the dude for 100? I ain't trying to run. Neither one told me he had to pick him up. Nigga sitting on my plays, man. Making it harder with sitting on my plays and shit. Watching my streams and shit, I don't be liking it. But I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yo, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fateful mistake, cause the timing up. Get a pass in my mind, don't get much luck. If you're once in my head, then you call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Do you take from the rich and the poor and us? Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs in a time you create where there ain't no love. But still got a reflux. I drip out from the socket to a teacup. Drink up inside. Look when they peep us. Choose us in the belly of the beast. But outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawk see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising. Abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising. Thinking what type of knowledge gonna sink in. Life gives you limits and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty. Will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Bridge of advance, Rana. Every way, put me in the water for the save. They don't know my name. I'll get through the pain. See there. On my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. They don't know my name. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Lemonade, lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
Yep. won't fall again, and I put that on me. Yeah, I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve. That's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come for the win, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, hey, champion, yeah, we here. Yeah, yeah, this the winning team. Six rings with a pinky ring. Everybody used to pick at me, now I'm the one that they picking. Snakes out, they hissing, but I can't hear when the crowd screams. Still balling like an offspring. This for all the ones that doubted me. Gotta lose once to be a true winner. Only want the hundreds with the blues in it. Eating blood across it, where the blood dinner. Juice stay turned like, you know. I've been through that water like Olympic swimmers. Only bread and butter, what we ate for dinner. So I had to dream it till the dream is bigger. Only want the gold, we don't need the silver. Gotta be number one, number two never count. Used to have bubble guts competition, now pouring them out. Making my babies proud, wanna cop my mama a house. Coming straight out the south, got enough juice to end the drought. Yeah, I buy like 23. Won't fall again, and I put that on me. Yeah, I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve. Yeah, that's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come for the win, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, yeah, champion, yeah, we here. Share my goals, I do not feel ashamed. I'm a dog, I'm a beast, and I cannot be tamed. I don't do it for fame, it's the love for the game. I go in like I'm trained. I'm prepared for the rain, they amazed. I ain't break from the sticks and stones they threw. Anything that you could do, I could do it better than you. No matter what I do, achieve, still got something to prove. I spent the check on the diamond cross, but still ain't paid my dues. Gotta be number one, number two never count. Used to have bubble guts competition, now pouring them out. Making my babies proud, wanna cop my mama a house. Coming straight out the south, got enough juice to end the drought. Yeah, I buy like 23. Won't fall again, and I put that on me. Yeah, I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve. That's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come for the win, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, yeah, champion, yeah, we here.
You talking about that bad movie that's on Netflix? Yeah, I seen that shit. Yeah, bears ain't dumb, them bitches smart as hell.
You see me fighting, goddamn, baby. You better hope that best. Come on, me boy. I ain't getting it, bro.
You ain't getting it?
Nah, I ain't getting it. I get a PS5. Look at him attack me. You think you said? 600.
Hey, Milo.
What?
You better play that nigga Glizzy. He goddamn ready to give it away, boy. He ready to play goddamn Buddy back for $1,000.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Billy got a ghost.
Damn! Why does that keep happening to me, dog?
Billy got a ghost. I got homies that can sleep with the DOA when I'm with 30. Walk up in the spot like they were
popping in. Go pop it for me cause I'm rich and popping in. God damn, rip my nigga neck off. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit.
You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it.
For a coup, I don't know, Lala was the only one in here talking to that, man. My girls head to toe designer. Him and Glizzy been having good games though. I mean, their games been straight.
Yeah.
Yeah, they been straight. Glizzy had him one game, he fucked it up. Fucked that bitch up. $180, he blew it. Shit, Milo, you probably got a good chance, bro. You probably got a good chance, bro. Yeah.
Who did that? Who did that? That nigga's
standing. That nigga betting that money, boy.
That be scamming. Rhino, you might want to hang up. You talking about anything else? 600. Just say don't worry about it. And everything around me, I can't see. Took it was a rose. Galilee rolling thunder, don't hear my cry. Don't let alibis catch you. I finally shot until we realize never give up. Think they were shocking. Right to you, you saw a lot. Try to try and go ahead if I everybody want a straight answer. The booty, it can't be blind. It's hard. It's not hard to find. Right before we try to find infrastructure. Right on that time. Infrastructure. Right on that time. Okay. It's all too. We're talking about to protecting the sons and daughters from political mislaughter. Tell me how cause I'm on fire. What up? What up?
What the fuck is this thing? What the fuck is he doing in my game?
They were selling the bitch for 900. I can wait a little bit longer.
Man, come on, bitch.
I know you blame. You have to play a lead, yeah. Come on, I'm dying. You hear me? You playing or what? Huh? So I need to start my game.
Oh!
Who you getting for the Giants? I ain't gotta get AD, I don't know. I just want Aiden, I'm...
Damn, reach out, motherfucker! Oh.
I'm goddamn... Again.
I bet you ain't beating on me. Trying to tell me how to get in the bag. How you beating on me and I'm up? Alright, nigga, that's enough. Shit. Man, no, you stop playing with motherfuckers. He wasn't going no motherfucker with you.
Got some Dolphins, the Vikings.
Oh my God. Get swift, the bitch.
That I came up, I know my granny gonna pay for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like
a PS5. This shit, you can't run plays back to back. Type shit on long.
Lukey's can't care what's still private. I might just double it up. Did it never enough? I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the bench. Whole team got wins in the world. So spinning, I told them.
what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in the drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got a break in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and a slot to the click.
Yeah, right now.
I got odds, if you drop, I just split my dance. I was caught, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10, 10 cents. Who really holding it down, I've been holding it down, and I go to it again and again. Who is the dummy that got, I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the what, I'm in the dead, I'm doing 30, I'm 30 and up. You in the what, you in the way, either you rolling the dust, you better say what. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan.
Oh, come on, baby. Good time.
Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on
Rhino.
Top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan.
Oh, I'm about to fucking say. I'm about to say.
Rhino. Where the fuck Rhino go, bro?
I don't know. Oh, fuck. That should have. He dropped it, though. That should have been a pick. Damn, that should have been a fucking pick.
Man, I'm finna go, man. Ride on bullshit.
I called him. I don't know where the fuck you went at.
They gonna call dude. I'm calling.
Pick! Haha, let's go! Good shit, boy. Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made this, you're labeled amazing. Particularly super, such a force of nature. Boss. I don't wanna seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle pockets, LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I wanna see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that. It's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where you're permanent. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Man,
what the fuck? Come on, man. You know what was in their hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that liquor, see you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a fool. Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie, looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, they need to go open up the briefcase, see with your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa time, but never seen a day in the rain in the front line. Don't lie. Stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space group, with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit. I've been groomed from the womb, came out of my mama. Man, I hate this one attacker shit. He got out of the, he said he's playing Call of Duty right now.
Game over, time's up. My car's got my hand in.
man, really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Do what I put, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bitch, you can't do it like me. All my winners on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Jumping toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. $40 on the truck. I had a dream in the store. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. That's why I be hella low-key. The contrary to belief. Loyalty runs deep. I cannot enter the streets. Struggle turned me to a beast. I'm out the chain, I'm out the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately I've been scheming. Against all odds like Billy Beeman. I've been grinding lately against my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Laying all on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all and no dreams attached. Can't roll no bottle, roll through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, you gon' act.
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs dead. I remember sleeping with my ribs dead.
Oh, God. Damn it, Joe! Yes, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
You can fall or you can
thank you.
I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch you paint, watch you learn. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt. Above the waters, in the murks, out the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight. Set the bar, take flight. Yo, I've been grinding since the youngin', they told me my timing was coming. I've been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame with the money. I'm out in LA where it's sunny. I've been eating since the youngin', since we ain't have food in our tummy. The life we was living ain't funny, but you cannot take nothing from me. Put that on my mama, my daughter, my cousin, my brother, I showed. Way better than I could take. The type of dreams that they say. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I'll see it later. To keep it real, you don't need to wait up. Lay it all on the line, ain't no looking back. Give him my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, roll through the cracks. Spotlight on you, behind you,
hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs dead.
Man, are you fucking kidding me? Get that bitch. That was big, right there. Damn, that was big. Go get that Mostert! Damn, Mosty! Fuck! Go get it, go get it, go get it. Fuck, man. Damn. Come on. Oh, this nigga went over there out of all fucking places. Ain't that a bitch? I should've went to Tevin Coleman. That bitch was wide open. Damn, I should've went to Coleman. I'm fucked up. Come on, run it back. Let's go. I'm up 15. Come on. Oh, no, I had a touchdown. I should've went to the Tevin Coleman. Wide the fuck over. Nigga, you wasn't, nigga, you wasn't getting back over there, nigga. You ain't no way you was getting back over that bitch. Hell no. I like that little setup right there. God damn. Mostert and Coleman, one of them bitches gonna get the break. Nah, that shit different. Coleman, that bitch gets extra motherfucking separation. Come on, nigga, I got a couple games in for my girl game. Come on. I'm up 15, let's go.
Got it, see my jewels, shining, white diamonds, Miley Cyrus, private jet, private pilot, look at me, stylish.
I hear your game right there, Rama. No, we're a bit to 15. Hell nah. Yo, I'ma tell you right now. I got, what color you got on? I got two games in me that I'm off this motherfucker. Two games, I'm letting you know now. One or the damn other.
Spin the block around just like the hair in the clock. Come like the battle in hell, I get you the cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like a beat of 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a bear in a message. You're the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you were scary to me. Heard you just need it, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, a cheetah, one with that air in the suit. And I feel just like a cheetah prince, and I'm an heir to the suit. I mean, for real. Touch the gravity sauce, so I don't even grab the bear. That's around my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I need a couple men.
Hey JP, who you playing?
Jay-Z?
Let's go.
0-0, that nigga just won. He won that one. I won the one before that one.
Yeah, I ride with him, JC. JC, hold on. Who got ball? Well, no details.
Literally the first fucking.
Yeah, we lost JC for 10.
Hey,
JC, if you, I'm finna get off. If you write in the chat, JC, write in the chat and let me know who won. I see my money, JC. I got your cash up already, bro.
Range just like Tom Brady. Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on his head. You know, make him throw a flag. Let my pass come through stench. Call me Todd Gurley, hit the hole, then I'll rent it. You know, you ain't trying to get that second flag on the plate.
You say that all the time. I'm just tired of them last drives, little glitchy ass last drives that they give you to get out there to score. And you don't be doing this shit all game. That's what I don't like.
In Atlanta, when it's time to scramble, neck full of water, call me Black Bridgewater. Lamar Jackson, throw them Ravens across the border. You know,
come on, where you go? Oh, he not in here no more.
Who?
That Lala nigga.
Shit, you wanna play Milo ass?
I play Milo.
Hold on, let me hit him up. Cause he was just in here looking for, a game.
Can I kick it? Don't ask me a thing. How I got a high did it? Can I kick shit with Green Bay? You can do that shit. Who up today, JC? You up on Titan up or he up on you?
I'm up on him right now.
Oh, he lost 300 to this bum ass nigga this morning like a dummy. I'm trying back to 700. What Milo say?
I'm waiting on him to hit me back now.
Got one last 50 before I get out this bitch or 20, whatever. Fed up with this, man. This is gonna be my last week gambling with this. This shit trash. No money in limo,
bro,
you know that nigga. Party going. Money still going, man.
Hold on. You mean to tell me you got a 54?
20, 25, 50, either or. He responded back to you?
Nah, I'm waiting on him to respond now. Better yet, he on the duty. Send it. You his friend on here?
Mm-hmm.
Send him a message. He on the duty. Send him a message on the game.
Oh, I ain't doing all that shit. I'm gonna send him an invite. That'll catch his attention.
Oh yeah.
We gon' probably just not the same no more. Really.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Garoppolo. There you go.
What teams y'all got?
I got the Niners. He got the Raven.
You playing with the Niners?
Yeah, man. No, I'm talking about. I done played JC at least. This got to be about our motherfucking what? 12 fucking 13 game today. No bullshit.
Jeez Louise.
Back to back, boom. Back to fucking back. And see, it's getting even harder because he's sitting on my plays and shit. You know what I'm saying? It's getting hard as fuck. Sitting on my shit.
Run some new shit then. If you want to try shit, some new
what,
shit.
That's what I'm trying. I'm trying to do new shit. That's what I'm doing now. You right, because John Madden been on your side all day yesterday. Damn, man, why you... motherfucker. Hell no, he was getting ran down. Them boys, they run his ass down. He wasn't going no damn career. Like I say, that nigga getting ran the fuck down. Yeah. Woo! They let that nigga catch that motherfucker. Play call. God damn. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm here. I play you with no custom, bro. I don't know where I'm gonna gamble you. You just wanna play one? Alright, send it. You can play.
Go on, let me gamble. I gamble him.
Oh man, no fumble? That's a fucking fumble!
Yeah, I know, I play him.
Come on! Damn, they doing it like that.
I tried to kill
that motherfucker.
I'm trying to gamble, man. Fuck.
I'm trying to make playbook anyway. That's funny. You gonna send it, big bro?
Damn,
bro?
I got cold in my eye and shit.
Oh, I forgot you made a new what you call. Alright, hold on.
Let me know if Milo coming out of that.
How did I know they was gonna let Calais Campbell do that right there just now? Jump there. Good time. What? What are you gonna do? A good job?
Us to North Carolina and Bank of America Stadium here in Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Seattle Seahawks. And this one travels out of bounds, so unsuccessful there on the onside kick try.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Yeah, for real. Nigga, I feel like every grown man should have baby wife, bro. Real talk. Yeah, that's the only way, bro. Hey, bro, if you think about it, if you don't use baby wipes, bro, you don't have a stain. That's fact. That's fact shit right there, dog. No bullshit. Hey, look, dude, so just think about it. You wipe your ass with tissue. Nigga, you ain't got nothing behind that shit. Nothing. Just old raunchy old ass.
Exactly right,
it could be a very long. No, man, goddamn, dog, that in. Oh, man, yeah, this, I don't know. But that's the only thing I hate that they let Lamar just, like, ain't no fucking all right, way, all right, man.
I'm ready.
Long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
So from the 36 now, first
you need
to
point
10.
About that, but that bitch turning around doing all that goofy shit. I understand the speed on the game, but the throwing part, I don't understand that, bro, because that nigga don't be completing shit like that for real, dog.
Lose yardage on the play back back at the 37-yard line.
Not off the fucking run like that. They be doing too much.
They'll cover him for a loss of a yard at the 37. Now left side on the swing pass. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Christian McCaffrey. No yardage to speak of whatsoever. Leads to a third down.
And 11.
Man, shit.
From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Flush to his right. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. 8-yard line. They'll try to run for it with Davis. And the Panthers are going to have it first and goal as he'll take this down to about the 3.
Jaren Reed.
And man, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line. Because ordinarily,
oh my God, man.
The end zone, the sidelines, is extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Again, they go with a fullback arm up. And they will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. It's the fullback taking it in. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Panthers 7.
Oh, good fucking pick. Good shit, my boy.
Joey slide out to kick off after the touchdown.
Let's go.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
It's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Got that one, though. He got that one. He got that one.
Wilson forced out to his left. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Jeremy Chin picks it up. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes it.
I don't know why my shit keeps doing that, man. 20,
13 yards, first down, Panthers.
First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And able to get about 3 as he's taken down right at the 20.
McCaffrey, the ball carrier. He's brought down at the 20-yard line. A 3-yard pickup brings up.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Here's McCaffrey. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Taking it in from the 20. And the Panthers, they widen.
Damn, man. And that's strong, too long.
Run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
God. Damn.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know it sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front. Offensive line collected victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
I did not make that. God damn it.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. They'll start out on the ground with Carson. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one. And what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
Ain't that a bitch? Ain't that a bitch?
Ball on the 30. Mm-hmm. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on 2nd down. They had the catch on 2nd down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at 3rd down here. 14-0 to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Seahawks nothing.
From the gun on 3rd down, Wilson dancing to his left. Going for Metcalf on the deep. And that's caught inside the 30. And he is going to have a Seahawks 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
This offense has been slow to get started, but that play will certainly give them a little bit of life. Maybe the late wake-up call that they have been seeking.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. Wilson, after the play fake to Carson, eluding the pressure right, letting one go deep for the end zone. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. To Tyler Lockett, 26 yards. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. Jason Myers now for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7.
Makes the score Panthers 14, Seahawks 7. Jason Myers to kick off.
Man, come the fuck on, bro. Now he's for the phone. Damn, he's for the phone doing that.
Here's Christian McCaffrey to return it. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
And he'll air this one deep for Anderson. It got his man complete. Touchdown, Carolina. Robbie Anderson, 73 yards. And the Panthers strike quickly here for 6 points. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Joey Sly to kick off for Carolina.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
21 yards.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Carson, the Seahawk.
Big Derek Brown making the stop. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6.
Second and 6 at the 44-yard line.
From the gun, it's Wilson being chased out left. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Wilson to lock it there for the Seahawk first down.
First down, Seattle.
Here's Carson. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. On 2nd and 7, Wilson steps away to his left. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 7 yards there and a first down. From the shotgun, Wilson. Flushed out right. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
They work again from the 38 on 2nd and 10. They go play action with Wilson. And caught left side, Olsen.
Wilson.
They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Nice 3rd down conversion and even 20 yards. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. This is Carson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
No gain on the play. Brings up 2nd and 10. At the Panthers' 11-yard line.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Wilson. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Corn Elder. And nothing there on the return. They've got the football, but they'll have to start this drive at their own 4-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3. We might look back on this in the 2nd half and say, you remember
when man, come on, boy. Who the fuck is that?
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and 1 yard. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
Oh, shit, I was back there. Damn.
It's second and 15. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Final play of the half, Bridgewater. Open man is Robbie Anderson. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say we'll see what happens. And likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. Here we go with McCaffrey. And this is going to come up well short as they stop him on fourth down. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL.
Oh, Lord. Audience Damn. Sports. We good, right, though. Coach, I'll take that over
you. We welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. It's a gain of 34. On first down, buying time to his left. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. And that'll bring up second down. They go play action now. Wilson. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Brian Burns. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. Escaping the pressure right. He lets it fly for Lockett. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. That's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL.
No, no, just let out of here, Paul.
Keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that.
JCA.
Another incompletion.
I'm losing right now, Paul.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. Flush to his right. He's going to fire one. Corner of the end zone. And it's incomplete. They cannot.
And he still ain't the bitch. Drop the ball.
Seahawks go for it, but can't convert. And the Panthers will get the football back. First down throw for Bridgewater. Eluding the pressure right. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Curtis Samuel, the one he was looking for. But it's going to be second down.
Griffin there defensively.
Mm-hmm.
From the gun, Bridgewater. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. Able to corral him right at the midfield stripe following that sparkling
Rhino
display of footwork we saw. That'll leave Fox,
are you ready?
Third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to 43.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive end, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. The intended receiver there, Ian Thomas, and it'll bring up third down.
I'm looking at this one by defensive eyeglasses on, because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 18. It's a Carolina first down. Back to the ground attack here is McCaffrey. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
Brought down at the 20-yard line. It's a pickup of 6.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And he'll get this one down to about the 17.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves and start to try and pound them into submission.
Oh, shit, get there! They've controlled this. Man, he caught that! Stop playing with me, man.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8.
Good game, bro.
Third and 2.
I'm done too. My girl coming. My girl about to pull up.
The man is Anderson. Taking across for Panthers touchdown. Robbie Anderson on the touchdown pass from Teddy Bridgewater. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
Partner, they had a good lead as they went in.
Ronald, say who you got for his Carolina Panthers.
To extend it. I love their consistency. Don't worry about what they said at halftime. This seemed like a team that was ready to play 60 minutes. And while this game is far from over, I love their approach.
Extra point.
GG, you were done.
And the lead down to 3 touchdowns at 21. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and it's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went 4 and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
To throw again on second down. Wilson. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit them over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
Wilson now from the gun on third down. A pass underneath for Carson. And they get it down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 12, first down Seahawks.
First down Seattle.
Wilson will throw again. Forced out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Play action. It's Wilson. Flushed out right. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time. Wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Operating from the gun, Wilson. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. The Seahawks on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and 17. He's going to air it out for Dorsett. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Corn Elder. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of a big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
The first play of the drive there is incomplete. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Third down and
the Panthers on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is third and 11.
All right, I'll be back on this later. Man.
Here's Bridgewater. And that will be incomplete. It was Trey Flowers that time who got a hand in and broke it up.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Now Bridgewater on fourth down. Got his target, Samuel. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? Bridgewater on first down. Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
Bridgewater here to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. L.J. Collier in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off inside the 5.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
After the interception, here's Wilson. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their 4th pick of the game. Instead, 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 10.
Play action. Now Wilson. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. On third down, Wilson. Dance the man. He's going to go down right near the goal line. The officials look at each other. They're going to mark him at the one-yard line.
A loss of 2 yards.
So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last
Parker
game?
Boy, I play you for team, bro.
But what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever. Whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.
Rondo, you want to run it back? Yeah, just send it whenever you're ready.
I don't know. Who you playing with? Panthers again?
They wanna be some. You gotta go berserk.
Okay. Sometimes you need a friend.
Not Parker, the ones relax. That show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that live right, in the game wanna see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. I'm saying, you like, come on, come on, sometimes like chill. You
want to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that
you,
wanna keep you
on your toes. You can only play with one team, dude.
No, I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need
this time you pick them on me, I'm picking Green Bay on your ass. You
respect,
give them more than what I get, expecting nothing back.
In fact,
you know, I
said, well, you know, so I got bad news. Okay. I said, what's the good news? You said, the good news is you made a lot. Okay. I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more. Okay, look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but in front of bay. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay, but wait. Jugging on the main stage, the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacation. Meditate, hydrate. Protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled
that. You getting on the 5 or the 4, Ronald? Ridiculous with words, such a force of nature. No, I say you're getting mad on the 5 or the 4.
But that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, away from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle pockets, LID. Distinctive destinations.
It's like more people gonna be on the 4 than the 5. It's 3 different ones a week. It's like more people gonna be on the 4 than the 5.
Mess around and put that thing up where your permit.
I'm saying the fire hard to get.
The NFL on EA Sports has come to the Twin Cities at US Bank Stadium in downtown Minneapolis.
You ought to get
the scene a short time
league.
Ago.
Money
this
league.
Crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with the Carolina Panthers. Joey Sly, the kicker, stands ready, and we are underway from downtown Minneapolis. This will make it into the end zone. Dropped at the 21-yard line, so bringing it into the end zone.
That's
not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
I really can't play with Russell. You don't want to see me with the motherfucking Chiefs. Oh my god. For everybody else, Russell can run and throw. For me, he was off. I know you seen them couple that went out of bounds, especially that touchdown. Anybody else, that shit would have got down. Alright, I'm ready, Ryan. Watermelon Ryan. I know you want to run with Hunt all day. I think that's his name. I was talking to myself. I said, I know you want to run with, what's the detail about that, Cook? Run with Cook.
Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. Also give him a first down. CD always more eyes on these night games, and they started it off nicely there on that run.
Yeah, and you're exactly right. Don't think for a second these players don't know and understand that. They want to impress their peers across the league. They also want to win the ball game. That's the way. Popped into the air and intercepted. Picked up by Troy Pride. A very good return to take it all the way up to the 40-yard line. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one. Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared, but I'm with you. Okay, so didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. First out of the gun, Bridgewater. He'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down.
And the Panther first down.
To throw, Bridgewater. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Curtis Samuel.
They're going to use a game park of war right there.
And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Now the extra point try forthcoming.
He's going to play free legs.
And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead.
I've been back on you. Sorry, it's a free leg.
Joey Sly to kick off.
Oh, hey, I remember back when you were sorry as hell, bro. You used to run three deep all day. I remember you came a long way, bro. For real.
This will make it into the end zone.
What the hell you gonna do?
Doula will not try to bring it out.
At their own 25.
Now you
found
your little blitz. You were using it last year.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. It could give the call there on first down as he works his way forward for a nice gain of 5.
Brought down. All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Give to Cook out of the gun. And to the 39. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
From the gun, it's a give to Cook. Jeremy Chinn there defensively. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Now, left side, the completion is deep in. And they're going to first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 43. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 43. From the gun, here's Cousins. Escaping the pressure right. They'll try and run it. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. The last drive, remember, in a similar situation, he forced the ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off.
And he will score. Touchdown. Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
First and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
First down, Carolina.
To the right side and complete to Thomas. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. These two teams all tied after one. able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Throwing is Bridgewater. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
An eight-yard pickup. First down, Panthers.
To the air again with Bridgewater. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 23 yards, the final tally.
Gain of 23 yards. And the Panther.
And again, it's Bridgewater. Short throw to the tight end, Thomas. Give him nine there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one.
And a yard at the 25-yard line.
They'll throw again. Bridgewater. This is caught. A good pickup there of 22.
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. From the 2 now, second and goal.
It's a gain of a yard. Brings up
again, McCaffrey. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. Can this Vikings D hold up one more time? Third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the 1.
1-yard line.
From the gun, Bridgewater. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Anthony Harris. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The good old cover 3 defense, partner. When you start playing football as a safety, that's the first thing you're taught. Middle of the field, be as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, and break on the football when it's thrown and pick it off, just as we saw there.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Second and 11 at the 19-yard line.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. I know he's easy. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Down left side on the swing pass. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. Calling a pickup of 7, and that'll lead here to a third down. Cousins gives way to Cook, and they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
On fourth down, they do snap it to Cousins.
Saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender. Yep. From there, he doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point right down the middle, right, and that makes the score 14-7. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start the... And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity.
The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts.
Ooh, the hell out, yeah,
as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
I can't pick a new
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. There's a quick throw to Thielen, and he'll be out of bounds right around the 20. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down.
That's
incomplete. Like what they tried to do there, tried to hit him with something quick, get the ball in his hands, and hope he could make some yards after the catch and pick up a first down. Weren't able to do so on that play.
And now they're going to go for it. This isn't fourth and inches. This is fourth and 14. They'll indeed go for it. It's Cousins. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Well, this is taken. It is complete. Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in corner number two. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Again, it's Cousins. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
That'll be complete to Cook. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. Cousins again. Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And he will have the Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Cousins on first down. Flush to his right. He's going to go up top for the end zone. Dalvin Cook is running back, the intended target, and it's second down.
Incomplete. Brings up second and 10 at the 24-yard line.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. They'll throw again. Cousins eluding the pressure right. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Throwing again, Bridgewater on second and 10. That's going to be caught by Samuel. He's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain there of 21 yards. from Viking territory now. They'll come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Being chased out left. Incomplete.
Well, my initial thought was that maybe he was just trying to blindly throw this one away, and maybe he was. But he's going to get away with it because as he tried to throw it over the left sideline there, there's a receiver right there in the area. So no grounding call.
Bridgewater able to get this to Thomas, his tight end. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. Bridgewater again.
Defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
And they'll try for it here on fourth. Bridgewater and company stay out there. Bridgewater, a play fake to McCaffrey. He'll look to throw. He's going to air one out for Anderson. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Robbie Anderson, 36 yards. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game. Even more so than a two-touchdown lead,
Parker
right?
Boy
because
got there.
You've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Joey Sly now, the kickoff after the touchdown. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
At their own 28-yard line.
Yeah. I don't play Parker, man. Parker don't have a
Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down.
Interception thrown by Cousins. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. But when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass.
I'm trying to come back to that.
From a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards a quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball. Whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback, you have a much better opportunity.
3 yards the gain there, second down. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he'll go down at the 28. 7 yards there and a first down.
A gain of seven. And a Panther first down.
Out of the gun, Bridgewater. And a pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 38. And Danielle Hunter. He's the one who gets in there and brings him down to the ground. Anderson, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Harrison Smith. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. It's a gain of seven, and that'll make it second down.
It's a gain of seven. Brings up second and three.
From the shotgun, it's Cousins. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And finally taken down at the 35-yard line. That one a gain of 20 and a first down. again. It's Cousins. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. That catch good for only a couple. Now second and eight at the 32-yard line.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Johnson was the intended receiver. Third down here. From the gun, here's Cousins.
Thank you.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Jeremy Chin picks it off. The 20, 10.
That's what it is.
And this one barely gets a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
Yeah, man. Good game. Depends on you. I gotta go piss while I cook you, nobody want that.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. It's certainly hot outside here in the desert, but somehow this Cardinal crowd turned up the heat a moment ago. They were in a frenzy as their team emerged from the tunnel, and the Cardinals, they're set to do battle with the Los Angeles Rams.
Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
Here's the kicker, Zane Gonzalez, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Glendale. A short kick taken at the 18. They get it out past the 30.
At their own 32-yard line.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Okay. I know I don't know shit. So these boys in here don't know shit.
Now the first carry for Cam Akers. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's second and 5 now from the 37. From the gun, here's Goff. And give this to Akers out of the backfield. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First down, Los Angeles.
Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking off. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. Offensively, a far from ideal start there with a pick on the opening drive.
Yeah, not exactly what they were looking for. We know that. That's pretty obvious. The beauty, though, is it's happening early. If they don't panic, they don't compound this problem, they've got a long way to go and a chance to get back in it.
After the turnover, here's Murray. And he'll go underneath here to Drake. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Yards on the pickup. It's second and inches.
A first carry for Kenyon Drake. And inside the 20, the first brought down. 11 yards there, first down. Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back to back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early, because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they've got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
And he'll get them inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brings up second.
From the gun, Murray. Hopkins has got it. Touchdown, Arizona. DeAndre Hopkins there to make the grab. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead. And the Cardinals will go up 7-0.
Makes the score Cardinals 7, Rams nothing. Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Fields this way up at the 17. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
First and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll run out of the gun, Akers. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now.
6 yards. And it's 3rd down.
A shotgun snap for Gone. Their throw complete to Cam Akers. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. First down, Los Angeles there with a pickup of 14 yards.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
I hate when they're going to use another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. Now Goff on first down. Flushed out right. He's going to take off with it. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
2nd and 1.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Goff. Too shy of the 30. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Rams.
Out of the gun. Goff. Escaping the pressure right. That's a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was in search of his tight end, Tyler Higbee. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
It leads to 2nd and 10.
Goff now looks to throw. Flush to his right.
You got so much defense out here.
And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. So back-to-back incompletions. 3rd down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range, so now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
And a 3rd down throw incomplete as well.
As my dad used to tell me all the time, when you're getting ready to play a big time game, especially when you have one going into a dome setting, better strap it up tight because that crowd can really affect things.
Especially on 3rd downs like the one we just saw there with the incompletion. And this one is right down the middle. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays. Yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later.
You came back for
another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down the defense.
25-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, and you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down. After 1-7-3, the score on EA Sports.
7, Rams 3.
Murray now on first down. That's in the hands of Gaffney, complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. It's another first down and what'll be a gain of 21 yards. And there's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays. And did he hang on to it? He did on the dive. Nice grab. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. Again, they'll throw with Murray. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. On 2nd down, it's Drake. In for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
I mean, people are still going to do it.
Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away.
fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
Get that little white boy.
Brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
First and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks. He can rack up those tackles in bunches in the run game from that middle linebacker spot.
And what he has to do is make sure he congratulates the guys in front and tells them thanks a lot, because as the guy in the middle, the Mike linebacker, you're counting on your front three, your front four, front five, whatever you've got in front of you to take up all the blocking, allow you to roam and hit. And that's what he did on that play.
That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. There's Goff. That's into the hands of Akers, complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll be a second down.
And four at the 42-yard line.
Eluding the pressure right. Got a man open. It's Tyler Higbee. He's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. On first and 10, Goff. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Double team and it's intercepted. Picked by Deontay Thompson. The 40, 20, 10. You got it! And they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown. That's a tough spot as a quarterback, Charles. You want to get rid of it, but you see what can happen when you do try to get rid of it with pressure.
Yeah, and how about the pressure coming without them having to blitz? That's when you know things are clicking for your defense, and the end result, they end up gaining 6 points.
Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
Everybody in one, Z.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fields this way up at the 17. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And following the pick six, and then decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football.
Oh, you? I know
he's
getting
better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give it
a
chance to rest.
And that'll be incomplete. Boy, took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. Back to throw. Goff.
Need it.
And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Now let's see how the offense still out there. They elect to go on fourth and 11. They're going to go for it. It's gone. He throws, and this is going to be incomplete. A surprising move to go for it, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. Then the Cardinals will now take over with excellent field position. So first and 10 now from the 30. Shotgun now for Murray. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Given six on the play. A second down.
We do it.
Brings it out of the gun. Here's Murray. Flushed out right. And then he is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals.
Good game, Ryan, though. Huh? Okay, hey, I'm gonna take a little break right quick, but I'll play you a little later. Try to bust on your ass.
I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the